最近香港兴起一片高科技热潮，好多人都话呢个就系香港嘅出路。特首董建华仲三番四次提到要向以色列学习。呢度系一个俾小朋友玩嘅科学公园。以色列嘅成功唔在于硬件建设，而在于政府放喺人民身上嘅投资。呢度系以色列最顶尖嘅科技研究中心魏兹曼研究所，学生都系嚟自世界各地嘅奖学金高材生。以色列政府希望透过学生之间嘅科技交流，扩阔本土科技嘅眼界。
没想到以色列这么个小小的国家，能是就是在科技上能如此发达。
鲍静系嚟自珠海嘅医生，修读紧博士课程，专门研究乳癌嘅成因。在出发来以色列之前，他心里面都有点担心。
从 CNN 上面知道以色列的情况，所有知道的东西就是以色列总打仗。
来到以色列，他一方面惊叹于以色列的科技成就，同时亦深深感到以色列的成功是源于人民对国家的归属感。
犹太人的这种内部凝聚力确实还是挺高的，就是他们自己之间，就首先呢，你看在美国的那些或者各个国家的这些犹太科学家了，他们都非常向往回到自己的国家，就是说很多人都在国外，都是别的国家都是很好的实验室，就很好的大学供给他们非常优厚的待遇，他们都什么都不要，情愿回到以色列。
以色列在战乱中立国，经历了将近2000年的颠沛流离，以色列人好懂得怎样珍惜自己的国家。以色列和香港有很多相似的地方，大家人口差不多，大家都缺乏天然资源，大家都说要搞高科技。不过以色列政府就认定科技可以救国，积极很多。
We have to base our economy on technology, and we have to base our economy on knowledge, and consequently, the high technology industry is very adequate for Israel.
1989年，苏联瓦解之后，有近80,000名前苏联嘅犹太裔移民涌入以色列。以色列政府不但没有好像香港特区政府那样以人数太多社会难以负担为理由拒绝他们，反而积极想办法将负担变为资产。移民当中有很多是科学家和工程师，政府于是推出科技培育计划，用共同开发方式帮助他们创业。结果10年之间，以色列由一个出产田产的农业国家变身成为一个科技小强国。1997年，他们的高科技产品总值接近港币700亿，占全国出口总值2/3。以色列的成功在于他的包容和兼收并蓄。Bora 博士是科学家，对科技发展了如指掌，亦因为咁，佢成为科技培育计划嘅评审员，即系以色列政府嘅高科技买板。佢每日都要周围去做评审工作，找寻值得政府投资嘅项目。呢日佢嚟到希伯来大学嘅医学院，评核一个研究医治艾滋病药物嘅申请。
Without the assistance and without the help of the governmental money, we will be unable to develop to carry up this work.
研究医治艾滋病新药是一个很伟大的构思，如果成功就等于打开一个金库。 但係一般投資者都唔肯冒險投資呢啲咁冇把握嘅項目。科技培育計劃係佢唯一嘅出路，因為只有政府先至肯冒呢個險。
It is a long-term development, and it's a lot of money-consuming and effort-consuming, and I think it's many times very risky. And if we want to have success, we need somebody stronger as a government to participate in the risk.
Did you do it just by trial and error, is it your original finding?
以色列政府视科技知识为国家财产，好着重原创精神。科技培育计划的申请人一定要是那项科技的原创人，而且当计划成功之后，绝对不可以将这种技术带到外国发展和生产。
The know-how should stay in Israel, and the production should be of the product should be in Israel, because that's what the purpose is.Building the industry in Israel, not building the profit of private people, but building the industry in Israel.
Nido 是以色列其中一个科技培育中心，没有造型生命的建筑，没有玻璃幕墙大厦，甚至没有一个似样的招牌。有的是无限创意的脑袋，这里每个窗口里面正培育着各种高科技的明日之星。这个800尺的房间就是其中一项创新科技的摇篮。 Thomas 博士研究着一种可以探测孕妇分娩时子宫颈伸缩状况的电子仪器，这个仪器如果研究成功，可以大大减低产妇分娩时的危险。在两年培育期间，政府会帮 Thomas 找资金和做市场推广，不过他首先要符合一些很现实的条件。
We have to convince them to do we have a potentially good business, good product that can result in a good business.
We hope that they will be able to earn money from what they have invested in, but it's a we believe that having built that building such an industryWill be do good for the whole community of scientists, for the whole community of people future to be working in the facilities, and this is part of supporting the country industry and not those private people.
科技培育计划在民间掀起一片创业气氛，催生了很多以色列本土的高科技公司，平均每日就有一间新公司诞生。
9 years after the program was set, it has a tremendous impact. And I'm not talking only about the level of venture capital investments, but really the whole idea of entrepreneurship.The whole idea of the importance of creating new companies, the idea of bringing in innovative technologies is very, very powerful.
以色列政府认为要发展高科技不可以依赖外国，一定要靠自己，所以很重视培养国民的创业精神。政府规定参与科技培育计划的公司一定要将部分股份分给员工，希望鼓励公司上下一心，齐齐创业。Ashton 教授，他想到可以利用镭射技术改良机械零件，但是他本身是机械工程师，不识镭射技术，唯有找阿 Joe 帮手。最后终于研究到用镭射光在零件表面转很多微细的凹位，减低零件摩擦时的阻力，机器亦可以运作得更加精准。由于公司刚刚起步，资金有限， Ashton 教授出不起市值工资请阿 Joe， 唯有用股份做补偿。而阿 Joe 亦都很乐意接受这个安排，因为他觉得公司自己都有份。
If you know a part of the company is yoursYou will reward yourself more because the company will be worth more. Sure, it's attractive because if you think maybe one day the company will be worth about $20 million, and you have a fraction of the percentage of that, half a percent of $100 million, you get half a million dollars. It's good.
由于以色列政府积极辅助和投资，超过一半参与科技培育计划的公司最终可以自立门户，茁壮成长。这种由政府同私人企业共同承担风险的做法，对于崇尚自由经济、相信森林定律的香港，又可唔可以接受呢？
It doesn't matter how much money you make, you be a scientist. That's much better. A scientist is a thinker, okay? So it's the education that we get. There is a high status to a scientist. If my daughter says she wants to be a scientist, I won't, you know, I'll be quite proud of her. If she wants to be, you know, if my son says he wants to be a businessman, okay, wonderful.
以色列人重视教育，尊敬科学，父母会因为仔女想成为科学家而自豪，而香港嘅父母就比较短视，多数只希望仔女读饱书，揾份好工，赚多啲钱。以色列系全世界科技人才最密集嘅国家，每一万人当中就有135个科学家或者工程师，抛离第二位嘅美国一大段距离，台湾排名第十。 而香港就完全唔入流。Honor Barry 喺以色列好有影响力，佢系政府嘅首席科学家，亦即系以色列高科技方向嘅掌舵人。佢嘅办公室系好多科学家嘅寻梦圣地，每日嚟向佢推销新科技计划嘅人络绎不绝。旧年以色列政府拨咗23亿俾佢发展高科技。 佢將其中10%投資喺科技培育計劃，其餘大多數都用嚟支持高科技研究同埋開發。佢覺得政府嘅資金有一個無可替代嘅角色。
Government subsidies for research and development that yields the additional spillover results that are beyond what companies, private companies and the venture capital firms would do to the economy. And is stimulating the economy. The growth of the economy is faster due to the fact that the government is being involved in the spillovers.
We have new ideas. We want to bring them to be attractive. And that's what we put the government money. Private money will not go into seed, what we call seed companies, very, very early stages.
呢間研究所係靠科技培育計劃起家嘅，可以話冇政府就唔會有佢哋。We
started as an incubator, meaning that at that stage the only people who believed in us were the government people.
以色列政府喺呢次嘅投資果然有眼光。呢間研究所93年攞住唔夠60萬創業，到咗今日，佢哋嘅市值達到4億，6年間升值650倍。
It's not just the issue of money, it's also the issue of support, backup. You know, you're not alone.
今时今日，呢间研究所绝对有能力自己集资发展，但系负责人 Java 教授仍然好热衷向 Aura 推销佢嘅计划，因为同政府首席科学家办公室合作，好有市场价值。
The chief scientist is handy because a lot of times your investors. Also look not at how much money you can get, but do you get the endorsement of the chief scientist's office, meaning that somebody's actually checking your work, somebody is actually monitoring that you're doing and you're performing what you aim or what you mean to perform.
在发展科技上，以色列政府只相信专家，所以负责的官员都是行内人或者科学家，明白行内需要。 而香港特区政府就行文官制度，往往由外行领导内行。今年九月初，以色列第三大城市海法有一个好盛大的农业科技展览，世界各地的农业科学家都云集捧场参与盛会。以色列政府希望藉这个机会交流科技，同时推广自己的国际形象。会场上九七回归前的香港旗竟然迎风飘扬，看来特区政府都要做多些宣传，而以色列就要多些留意世界的变化了。立国以来，以色列一直处于备战状态。九十年代中东局势缓和，以色列才开放自己，积极拓展国际市场。以色列的创意和科技水平相当高，风魔全球的 ICQ 就是三个以色列年轻人的杰作。不过他们精于发明，不精于发展，很快就将 ICQ 卖了给一家美国公司，自己反而籍籍无闻。以色列政府亦明白国外的管理策略和市场技巧和国际水平仍有一大段距离，急起直追，他们决定将知识直接进口。九七年，以色列政府宣布会发出第三个流动电话牌照，但是在落标条文里面就规定本地企业一定要同一间外国的网络供应商合作。
It's an issue of globalization because you want to have companies who are normally invested strategically in communications elsewhere, and they consequently you benefit from exposure to methods and the licenses and anything from roaming agreements to infrastructure technology.
由于有国防需要，以色列的通讯科技一向好先进，如果政府只是想增加一个流动电话网络，本地企业已经可以应付裕余。但是以色列政府希望利用开放市场来吸收外国经验，结果中标的是一个以色列和香港网络商合作的组合。 Ferrucci 是股东之一，他的公司一向以生产军事科技仪器闻名，拥有尖端的通讯科技知识，但是讲到搞流动电话网络和做市场推广，就要靠香港的拍档了。
What we developed was really solution systems and being an integrator of systems and developing high-tech gadget, I would say, or high-tech equipment. We were not an operator. Acheson brought the experience of an operator. Now, the combination of that two, that's the answer. That was the right, probably, that was the right answer for preparing the right proposal for the tender.
以色列的传统沉实朴素，不注重包装，从外表看这里几乎是一个没有颜色的地方。香港的网络供应商引入现代化包装概念，将店铺包装成色彩灿烂的连锁店，比起当地一般商店抢眼得多。 Keith 是香港网络商派驻在以色列的代表，他第一样要教给员工的就是
Customer is God. In Israel, the customer has not been seen as God until now.
这个我们已经习以为常的概念，对这班以色列雇员来讲竟然是一件新事物。而 Keith 的另一个决定就更加成为创举。
This store is open 1 hour longer than every other shop in this shopping mall. It's the first time anybody's done that in the country.
We are getting from Hong Kong as far as knowledge.In almost every area, both marketing, sales, the network itself, and overall the idea how to penetrate the market.
短短半年，香港的网络供应商就为以色列建立起一个 GSM 数码网络，引进130亿资金，创造1500个就业机会，充分发挥香港的强项。
Hong Kong is very strong not only in financial, it's also strong in business, in creation of logistics and business capabilities. Look at your airport. It's a fantastic logistic project and engineering project. So I think that the combination, the technology and innovation in the high-tech sector is certainly a characteristic of Israel. Financial and infrastructure capabilities are definitely strengthened.